Yeah. You know, sometimes I think they don't truly understand me, you know? Cause they don't. Yeah. Can't change the world unless we change ourselves. Die from the sicknesses if we don't seek the health. All eyes be my witness when I speak what's felt. Full house on my hands, the cards I was dealt. 3 K's, 2 A's in America. I'm just a blank space, born out the nebula. And everything I do will say today is worthwhile. With assurance by your action and your first child. I begin my first now. Sometimes I speak and I feel like it ain't my words. Like I'm just a vessel channeling inside this universe. I feel my ancestors arrested inside of me. It's like they want me to shoot my chance and change the society. But how do I go about it? Tell me where I start. My destiny rerouted when I chose to follow heart. You told to follow suit, but tell me what it do for you. Except where you down, now you trapped inside the cubicle they built for us. The first step in the change is to take notice. Realize the real gains that they tried to show us. 300 plus years of them cold shoulders. Your 300 million of it still got no focus. Sorry America, but I would not be your soldier. Obama just wasn't enough, I need some more closure. And Donald Trump is not equipped to take this country over. Let's face facts, cause we know what's the real motives. In the land of the free is for the freeloaders. Leave us dead in the street to be the organ donors. They disorganized, my people made us all loners. Still got the last names of our slave owners. In the land of the free is for the freeloaders. Leave us dead in the street to be the organ donors. They disorganized, my people made us all loners. Yeah. We can't change the world unless we change ourselves. Die from the sicknesses if we don't seek the help. All eyes be my witness when I speak with felt. Full house on my hands, the cause I was dealt.
Ho, come on in. Come on in, family. Come on in. Let's get on frequency. That's that boy Joey Badass. It's that boy Joey Badass. Cop that album. All American Badass. In stores, All American Badass. Yeah. Let's go, baby. You already know what time it is. Assalamu alaikum, salam, Imhotep Grand Rising Royal Family. Grand Rising. Hope you got your power bracelets on and you're on frequency with us today. Put your meditation bracelets on. Let's get it ringing. Let's get it ringing. Come on. Yeah. That's right, Money Boy Trey, Vibranium. Vibranium, shout out to that boy CG Potolo on a t-shirt. We'll get to that in a second on how you can get one as well. Since we're talking about love today, we finding love. We gotta talk about vibration, so it's only right that we rock this today. Let me get you guys the right angle so y'all can see. All right, here we go. Let's go, baby. Let's get to the first nine, first and foremost. Let's see who was up this morning and ready and on frequency with your boy. First one in the building, we got Tory Young. He got all his nines up. I appreciate you. He's from Durham, North Carolina. North Carolina in the building. Shout out to NC. I see you. Dominique Davis, thank you for putting your nines up. I appreciate you. Thank you for being on time as well. Eddie Sandige, the Mundo's Taunito to you as well. Eddie Sandige, I see you. I see you. Thank you. Thank you. A. Haley from Detroit. Detroit is in the building. Detroit's a lot of conscious people in Detroit, man. I got to tell you. You know, Detroit is real heavy. So definitely happy to have them in the building. Barbara Fitz. Barbara Fitz. Yeah, that beat is classic, right? It's like it got that 90s feel to it. You know, that's why I like Joey Badass, man. He kind of the last of a dying breed, really. He the last one that's holding it down, that's actually spitting something. So on a conscious level, you know, we need more balance. We need more of that. We need more Joey Badass. Adrian Barden, I see you. Peace, Queen. I love you. Thank you for being on. Peace, peace. Grand Rising. Rising Lily, 234. Greetings. I see you. Peace, Queen. How we feeling this morning? We also have Tanisha Black as one of the first nine. I see you. Thank you. Hey, no excuses. And Jay Taylor. That's right. That's badass. Jay already know what's up. She know who that is already. I appreciate you for being on the support. And support that, brother. Support that album, man. All-American Badass. That's in stores right now. You can download that. You can stream it. Whatever have you. All right. So we getting into finding love. Finding love. First and foremost, put your thumbs up. Make sure you click the thumb up button, the like button. And also, if you can, hit the subscription button and the little bell so you know you can get your notifications of when we're going to be on. All right? So, let's go. Finding love. When we're dealing with love, right? This is the reason why I want to talk about this is because in the conscious community, when you become conscious, right? I don't even want to say the conscious community, just in general, with it throughout the universe, right? When you become aware of self, when you become aware of who you are, right? You're going to run into some trials and tribulations. You're going to run into people or things or even places that don't vibe with you, that don't vibrate with you, right? And you go through a stage, especially when you first awaken, where you start to have struggles in these areas, right? Relationships, friends, right? And certain things that you used to do or certain places that you used to hang out, certain people that you used to vibe with, you no longer vibe with anymore, right? Things change. And that's all according to nature, right? It's supposed to at the end of the day. So we find ourselves in this paradigm where we're now looking for love in the early stages of consciousness, right? And I'm going to go into this a little bit to help you guys to redefine what love is, because now that you've left out of the matrix, their definition of love is very different from how you see it now. So we have to address some of these issues. So let's deal with the dictionary and let's see what it says about love. Okay. Love is an intense feeling of deep affection, okay? And it's synonymous with fondness, tenderness, warmth, intimacy, attachment, that's a big one, endearment, and more. Love is a person or a thing that one loves. You see, you know you're dealing with a strong word when they use the word to define it. A person or a thing that one loves is love. Is synonymous with beloved or loved one, love of oneself, dear, dearest, dear one, darling, sweetheart, sweet angel, honey, and more. Then it goes down to this as a verb, is to feel a deep or romantic or sexual attachment to someone. Care very much for, feel deep affection for, hold very dear, adore, think the world of, be devoted to, dote on, idolize, worship, and more. So what I want you to do as I'm going through this course today, I want you to think about what you yourself, how do you define love, right? In yourself, how do you define it? Because this is one of those areas where there seems to be blurred lines, right? They're using love to actually describe love. Why? Because they really don't have a clear definition on how to define it. That's what it is. And I think this is why, not even I think, I know this is why we have so much confusion when we become conscious in relationships and how we deal with our new environment, because we don't know how to love. We don't know how to find it. And I think that this is one of the problems that we have, is because when we deal with love, we're always trying to find love as if love is lost. As if love is lost. I'm sure when we find love, love probably says, I was always right here. Huh? If we had to talk to love, love wouldn't feel like they was lost. I'm sure love would say, I always been here. I always been around. Huh? So we got to really deal with this as is. So before I give you what, you know, what they told you about love, you know, we got to lay down the right law. We got to deal with what our ancestors defined love as. So let's get to it. We're dealing with love. We're dealing with Osset. We're dealing with Osset. Osset is the embodiment of those intuitive and instinctive faculties that lay deep within our psyche, governing our ability to care for and nurture others. People in whom this faculty is strongly developed are very protective, caring, and nurturing. These qualities amongst the Kamishans and other Africans were most desirable in mothers and wives. Okay? So now, a lot of our women, many of our women, they go through this issue of finding love. Why? Because they used to live by the previous definition of what they felt love was. And then as it changed, right, under the previous definition, when you deal with love as a verb, as an action, right, it tells us it's a feel of a romantic or sexual attachment. And that's very common in the matrix that we live in, that they tie sex automatically to love. You see, when you have people talking love and sex under the same breath, you want to be careful with that. You want to be careful with that, especially in this new diaspora, because now when you become conscious, you become more of a sapiosexual, right? Physical attractions and sex isn't the top. Are we back? Let's see if we're back. Have to switch it up on these guys. If we back, put your nines up. We get in the chat. All right, cool. So, when you become conscious, love is no longer a physical attraction as a priority now. That's not the priority. The priority becomes more of a sapiosexual environment where information, right, becomes priority, right? Intelligence, right? The use of that information becomes priority. This is the early stages of consciousness, okay? Now, this changes over time, but I need you to understand that change is good. Change is good. You see, because we've been doing this the same old thing for too long, right? And you realize that we need to make some changes, right? So you have to welcome that change when it comes in. Right? You have to be comfortable in being uncomfortable. Huh? Many of us, when we run into uncomfortable situation, that's when fear creeps in. And fear is the opposite of what? Love. Okay? There's only two emotions that you actually really have. That's love and that's fear. Okay? So when you become uncertain, which you're going to have a lot of that in consciousness, fear creeps in. Right? And then you're uncertain as to whether you are able to love, if you're capable of loving this person, or if this person is capable of loving you. Okay? And this is completely normal. Right? So when we're dealing with our set, we have to give you balance. We have to give you duality. If we're dealing with our set, we're also dealing with Asar. We're also dealing with Asar, her counterpart, her consort. Okay? If you look in the Medunetra, when you look at Asar, you look at Aset rather, this is how Aset is spelled. For those of you who have the Let the Ancestors Speak and you like to, you know, recognize her when you see her on the walls of Kemet. Okay, the symbols of the name of Aset are the throne. That's how you can figure out whether you're dealing with Aset. Sometimes we get Aset confused with Ma'at. Okay? A set has the throne on the top of her head, and the phonetic sign for which is the phonetic sign for T, and the determinative egg. Okay? She has the phonetic sign for T, which is that little loaf. You see that little loaf there? That's the T. Okay? And then the determinative egg. Okay? And the symbol of motherhood and the seated female as a determinative as well. Okay? So that's how you can recognize set in the a set in the Medinetra or Ast. Sometimes they say. She also happens to be who you see on my hat here. That is Ast. Okay? If you take a look closely, you'll see she has a throne on the top of her head. See if you can see that. She has a throne on the top of her head. Okay? So, it's important that you realize that if she's a symbol of love, she's a symbol of motherhood, and she has the throne on the top of her head, that's for a reason, okay? The divine feminine energy is very conducive when it comes to the aspect of what love actually represents, okay? This is something, if they know who they are, right? Put a star next to that. They can really embody what this truly is, okay? And we're going to get into a little bit of history too about this before we really dig in, but Ast, another name for Ast or Set is Marie. Marie, M-E-R-I, okay? Marie. And Marie, as we all know, Ast was the one who put together or resurrected Asar. Man, well, there ain't that much love you can really give more than that. You know, she brought him back to life. Do you understand? She took the pieces he was cut into pieces by a set. Okay? And she took those pieces and put them back together, all the limbs of his body, and resurrected him. Here she is with Anpu. Okay? And she is resurrecting Asar. Okay, 9 months later, they gave birth to what we have as Heru. Okay, Heru was born destined to battle his uncle Setek or Set. Set is the one who destroyed his father. Okay, reclaim his father Asar's kingdom and bring back order. You guys are the Herus. We are the Herus. Herus, you're supposed to self-personify with yourself. Heru grows up and decides it's time to face his uncle Setek in the battle for the throne of Kemet. Now, this story might sound familiar to you. It might sound familiar because it's the same story that they gave to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ dies. He's supposed to be resurrected, but in the meantime, he's down there fighting the devil so that he can reclaim the throne. Take back the keys from the devil. Huh? Sound familiar? You see? When they try to tell you that Heru is Jesus, yeah, that's one and the same. That's a whole nother story. We already know they stole that story from us. But moving on, we're dealing with Mary today. Let's tie in Mary. Because Mary is exactly who she is. She's our set. She is Marie. That is Marie. Okay? The embodiment of what they call love. Remember? Mary was infatuated with her son Jesus, right? She loved Jesus, right? They took that story from Orset's love for Heru. You understand? The unconditional love. They later changed the Black Madonna to the White Madonna. You see, you always know the real thing because it's going to be written in stone. And later on, you'll find some drawings pop up. And you go from Marie, which means beloved in the Medinetra, to Mary, which we have now. Okay? Or Set is the original aspect of love. Okay? One of my sources I'm going to be reading from is the Egyptian grammar book for Gardner, where you can go into the back and you can get the dictionary. Okay? and you can actually look up the word that I'm speaking in reference to. Okay, let's find it in the Medunetcha here. That way we don't have any confusion as to where this word actually comes from. So I'm going to show it to you guys here. One of the words for Egypt was Ta-Mari, which means, as you see here, pull it up here, love, wish, okay, the beloved. You know how they say beloved Mary? Here you see Ta-Mari, Marie, right? Could be in love, right? Ta-Mari, a name of Egypt. See that? So this is where they get the concept of Mary from, okay? That's where they get it from. We had it first. So, now that we've gotten that straightened out, before anybody tries to usurp Mary into this situation, right, or Jesus into this situation as the ultimate sign of love, I have to make sure that I establish that they got that from our story first, okay? Because this is the problem. This is why we have the situations that we have now. Because why? We're looking for love outside of ourselves, okay? All of the different religions take their aspect of Mary or Aset from us, as you can see. The Virgin Mother, or the aspect of love, and you can go all the way down the line from Christ to Buddha to Krishna, Hermes, Sakai, Yasoda, right? They all got that first and foremost from Marie. Okay? So let's be clear of where they got that from. Here you have the original drawing here. Like I told you, it's always going to be set in stone, of Aset resurrecting Asar. And you have his Ba and his Ka, which is those birds above him, right? That will represent his soul, his spirit, right? That's his Ba. Okay? So she's resurrecting him and bringing him back to life, already written in stone. Okay? So this is the first time that we see true love at its best. It's an unconditional love, even after death. You can't really get in any worse condition than that. You know, the biblical text says that there's no greater love than for somebody to give their life up for someone, right? But here in our text, it shows that the love was to be unconditional, whether someone's dead or whether someone's alive. That is an unconditional love. That's what the original definition of unconditional love was love even after death. Okay? There are even some animals in nature, they will only mate once. Even if their mate dies, they will not mate again. Okay? An unconditional love. Okay? So, for many of us, if we look at love, right, we like to associate love with how a person treats us, right? We associate love with how a person treats us. We don't love that person unless they treat us a certain way, right? Right? But what if I told you that's only the last leg of love? That's only the last leg of love, right? There are some people who are incapable of treating you the way that you want to be treated. Actual fact, they're just incapable, right? It all depends upon your values and what you value in life. Love is first and foremost based on how you feel about that person and how you want to nurture that person. Let's go back to Aset, okay? Let's go back to Aset. As you see here, people in whom this faculty is strongly developed strongly developed are protective, caring, and nurturing, right? Protective, caring, and nurturing, right? Now, before you can be protective, caring, and nurturing to someone else, you have to first be protective, caring, and nurturing of yourself. First and foremost, let's be clear. Let's be clear. I love this song that Mary J. did when she first came out. Right? She said, how can I love somebody else? Y'all know, come on now. If I can't love myself enough to know, right? When it's time to let go, right? We know that song, right? She says, all I really want is to be happy. We know that song. She's speaking the truth there. Because you can't love somebody until you first love yourself. This is what we're trying to teach, especially amongst black people, because black people have a problem with loving themselves. Loving themselves, right? They don't love themselves and they expect someone else to love them when they don't love themselves. Now, I'm going to give you a little hint, especially for my women here, because I know our women suffer from low self-esteem. They do, as a collective. And we have to talk about this. We have to be willing to talk about it, right? I'm going to tell you something about a brother. Let me tell you something about the divine masculine. You could have the baddest women out there, and they can't find a man. Baddest women, most beautiful, gorgeous women. They can't find a man, right? Then you can find somebody that's average or even below average of what we might think is beauty, right? Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, right? These women will go on and get married, have successful relationships, and live happy lives. Why is that? I'm going to tell you why from a man's perspective. Because a man will find a woman with good self-esteem, who loves herself, more attractive than a woman who's bad and has no pride or class in herself. That's on the gram, throwing out tits and butt all day, right? You see, a man might fall to sexual desires with that woman, but he's not wifing her up. Nope. Because he knows. That's a characteristic of low. That's one of the things that men have intuitively. We don't get fooled by that. We understand what good self-esteem looks like. That's one thing that we got. Huh? We'll go for the woman that truly respects herself. We will go for the woman. We will wife up the woman that we know intuitively loves herself enough. Right? To not put herself in those positions. To not put herself out there like that. That's a fact. But women don't understand that. Most, I would say. They fall to the cattiness, right? Of back and forth trying to compete with another woman. And that's because they don't have love of themselves. I've seen 400-500-pound women get married, right? No problem. No problem in their relationship. Why? Because she's confident. She's confident. She'll go and throw on them tight jeans, what? And walk down that block and strut her stuff. Don't care. It's confidence. You understand? She has a love for herself. Therefore, she can love someone else in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. And you know what? She's easy to be loved. Easy to be loved because she already loves herself. She doesn't need the love, but she welcomes it. She don't need it though. You see? You ever been around somebody that's needy? Huh? That's needy? Like, God, here they come. I know they're gonna ask. They need somebody. Every time you meet them, they need $1, need $10, $20. They needy. Huh? We tend, as human beings, we tend to help people that help themselves. We help people that help themselves. I'm going to give you an example. We're driving down the parkway, right? We see a car and it's pulled over on the side of the road. We just keep going. We just keep going. We saw the car. It was pulled over on the side of the road, but we just flew right past. Didn't even pay no attention to it. Now, same scenario. We're going the same speed. We're driving down the road and we see somebody. We see a woman and she's kneeled down, or even a man kneeled down and he's working on his tire. Right? Same car. But now we see the person outside and he's trying to fix a flat tire. We might pull over and help this person. Hey, you need a lift? Hey, you need some help with that? Oh, you need some jumper cables? Why? Because we help people who help themselves. You understand? You can't keep walking around feeling sorry for yourself, saying I ain't got no love, people don't like me. You got to like yourself. Huh? That comes with the territory. When you have love for yourself, people say, Dad, why does he love himself so much? I want to see what this person is about. Why does she love herself so much? Let me see what she's about. Yeah, you know what? She do strut that really pretty good. Let me see. You know what? I do see what she... You understand what I'm saying? They sell themselves. Love sells itself. It don't need promotion. You understand? It don't need a good filter on Instagram. Huh? It don't need Photoshop. Love don't need Photoshop. You can't even describe love. This is what's missing. We don't love ourselves. So this is what we try to do on this feed, is show you how fantastic you are. Huh? You have to walk in that fantasticness. Let it drip all over you. Huh? Let it drip all over you. So that your vibration moves in love. Huh? Everywhere you go, people feel a vibration. Yo, it's something about this cat. It's something about this girl. Nothing but vibration. You understand? It's love. You got a love for yourself. So therefore, people love you. Because you created that diaspora. You created a whole new matrix. Huh? I remember, it's only a couple months ago. I was sitting on the curb. We had people laughing. You know, what does he know? What does he know? He just sitting on a damn stoop. But I had love for myself. If I didn't have love for myself, we wouldn't be where we are here today. You understand? The lighthouse wouldn't be what it was if I didn't first have a love for Jamaar Milton. Do you understand? And the same goes for you. If you don't love yourself enough to even walk from a dangerous situation, to walk away from a dangerous situation, or walk away from people that have no love for you and just love yourself, don't expect the love to come. You understand? Anybody, especially that's dealt with music, right? A lot of them don't get love back home. As soon as they walk away or they move away from home and they go to a different state, all of a sudden everybody else in the other states, they love them. They love who they are. They love them. And then they come back. They say, yo, why you don't come back to the hood? Because y'all don't show no love. Huh? I had to have love for myself to go and leave y'all alone. Huh? And then I'll come back and show y'all some love. You know what I'm saying? Because if I stay here, y'all ain't going to show me no love. So you go to where the love is. Step two, love yourself enough to go to where the love is. That's it. Don't waste time trying to convince people to love you. You're wasting your time. These people aren't going to love you until other people love you. You see how that works? That means you surrounded yourself with followers. They're not showing you any love. You surrounded yourself with followers. So they're going to wait. It's called the Jones effect. When everybody loves you, they don't only just love you. Now they related to you. They was cousins. They was always around. Right? You know how it go.
Yo, that's my homie right there, son. Like, yo, we came up.
Right? Y'all know how that go. Welcome to the Lighthouse.
That's a fact.
So, learn how to love yourself enough. Let me go back to this definition here, because this is key. This is the part that I really like right here. Okay. It says, it's an attachment. Love is an attachment. Right? Love, it's an intense feeling or deep affection. It's an attachment. An attraction. Right? An attraction. Well, what if I told you, that sometimes you need to disconnect from an attraction to show yourself proven of true love? Because we're not just looking for any love, right? You're looking for true love. Sometimes you gotta walk away. I'm sure your mama and your daddy used to tell you, you know, if it's real, walk away. It'll come back to you. If it's real, let it go. It'll come back to you, right? Sometimes you have to love yourself enough to walk away from a bad situation. You can't love this person. Being with that person sometimes is dangerous for the two of you. So sometimes just letting that person go and do them is the ultimate sign of affection and the ultimate sign of love. It's not always being with that person that you define as love, right? That person might look at it as being disloyal when really you're just saying, yo, you know what? It's better that I not be with that person in this environment because us together is bad, you know? You can love something so much that you break it, right? You misuse it. Right? You can't hug a carton of eggs. It's too delicate. Right? That's going to be problems for the eggs and problem for you. Right? We love eggs, but you can't. Oh, I love it so much. Right? No, you can't do that. You can't do that, bro. You know what I'm saying? So, you got to understand that there's levels to love. Right? There's all different ways to love. And when you become conscious, you have to be comfortable in knowing that the way that you love someone is going to change. Love is not a destination. It's a journey. Love is not a destination. It's a journey. It's an ongoing process. You see? Because the person that you're in love with today is going to change over time. You see? Oh yeah, she bad now, but y'all only 19, bro. She ain't gonna look at that when she ain't gonna look like that when she 55. She ain't gonna look like that when she 60, 70. You see? Love changes. Right? So you don't want to fall in love with the outwardly appearance of a person. That's a small fraction, and that's going to change. That could change next week. That brother that you thought was fine, that brother that you thought was handsome, that could change next week, right? The grades start coming in. Hell, you could even have tragic accidents. Now he got one leg. You still love him? Huh? She developed cancer, had to get rid of one breast. You still love her? Huh? If that ain't the love that you're looking for, you ain't looking for love at all. You're looking for a reciprocation of yourself. I know some brothers, right? I know some brothers who say, yo, I want a girl, you know what I'm saying, that I could kick it with. You know what I'm saying? Like, we could play video games together, you know. You know, we could go to the football game and ride motorcycles. I'm like, bro, it sounds like you looking for a dude. You looking for a reciprocation of yourself, man. You understand? That's not somebody that completes you. You already got that experience. Right? Like, you don't sound like you looking for somebody that is filling up the holes or the gaps within your life. Right? That's the problem with dudes. We always looking for a female that can do certain things that we always like to do. Maybe she's not meant to do that. Maybe that divine feminine energy is not meant to be around that situation. Sometimes it's just meant for you to do those things with your homies and figure out a way, you know, that y'all can do those things together and still spend time with one another. Or see if she's willing to compromise every now and then. But you can't expect her to want to sit down and play video games with you every day. You can't expect her to want to go to every football game that you got. She's not into that. You understand what I'm saying? If you love her, you allow her to be herself. Stop always trying to change somebody. That's another thing about love. Always trying to change that person. Just let that person be them. Right? If you love that person, you love them for who they are right now. Right? If they need to change in order for you to love them, then your love is not based on genuosity. Right? It's based on something that you want to get out of the situation, not what you're trying to give. Love is a service. It's a service. You understand? It's not a trophy. It's a service. This is why we have so much hard times in the conscious community finding love. Huh? This is why. We think love is actually a trophy. I found love. Like, you dug in the damn ground and you found you a diamond or something. It don't work that way. You know, if I dig in the dirt and I find my stone, I'm like, I found love. I found it. This stone gonna be the same way it was when I found it. It ain't gonna change, right? Love ain't like that. Love changes. It evolves. It evolves. Every day is something different. Every day there's a new trial, tribulation, something that you go through, and you gotta change. You gotta be willing to love the change. You understand? When you see problems coming down the pike, when you see the storm coming, you gotta run towards it. Oh yeah, let's tackle this one. Because you know what? When we go through this, when we come out on the other end, we're gonna say, yo, look what we went through. Huh? That's when you're forming real stable love. Like, yo, look what we just went through, fam. Yo. You know what I'm saying? If you don't go through nothing, you ain't never been through nothing. So your love ain't stable. The real relationships are the ones that went through the trials, tribulations, and made it through together. Right? Not because of the love that they had even for themselves, the love they have for each other after loving themselves, right? I gotta be here. I gotta be strong for this person. You know why? I love myself enough because I won't be able to make it without this person. You understand? So because I love myself, I'm gonna make sure that my counterpart is okay, because I'm not okay if my counterpart is not okay, right? It's a revolving door. It's a process. A journey. And y'all both have to be on one accord. That's what love is about. Yes, it evolves. My brother Kevin Wesley, when he talks about love, he talks about evolving. Love evolves. If you haven't already, check out Kevin Wesley. That's my brother. Good dude. Love evolves. It changes. It won't stay the same. So, when we're dealing with the principle of Aset and we're dealing with the principle of Asar, Asar represents resurrection. It represents death, right? And she represents love, right? So there's a marriage here. There's a marriage between love and death, right? There's supposed to be a connection, meaning when you a true love will exist even after death. True love resurrects a dead body. You see? These are principles. These weren't actual people, right? These were principles, metaphorical principles, allegory, to teach you what true love actually feels like, right? This is the greatest love story ever, because he was cut into pieces, and she took his pieces and put them back together. That's love. She loved, literally loved him to pieces. You know, I love my ancestors, man. Like, it's just, it's amazing. It's amazing the legwork that they put down for us that's still relevant to today. She loved him to pieces. You understand? She put him back together. So with that being said, I hope y'all enjoyed that. It's time to give the shout outs. It's time to give shout outs. Okay. First shout out I want to give. If you don't know, we're doing Get This Work Wednesdays. What's Get This Work Wednesday? Get This Work Wednesday. The faculty of the Lighthouse decided to put together a quiz based on the information that I give you guys, based on the classes. And those who answer the quiz correctly, all answers correctly, and the quickest will receive a prize. So the winner of the first Get This Work Wednesdays goes out to, and we want to give her, show her so much love, it goes out to Queen Coco Chanel. So show her some love. She's the queen that got all the answers correct in reference to the quiz. And her prize is going to be a free Reiki reading from Sister Latifah Foster. She's going to get a free reading. And we're going to be doing this every week. The prizes are going to be changing every week. There was two runners up that I want to shout out. that's Genesis Rochelle and Terry Phillips. They all got their answers correctly too, but Coco Chanel was the one who got hers done the quickest and submitted her answers to the Lighthouse faculty. So if you'd like to be a part of this, you want to join the Lighthouse group on Facebook, just click just type in the Lighthouse in the search engine and it will come up. You do have to answer questions in order to get in there. So I suggest that you watch a couple of these videos from the Lighthouse before you try to apply for it. We will not let people in if they do not answer the questions, because we do have agents, we do have trolls and people that come in and try to tear down our classes and what we're trying to do as far as educating one another and building black people. So that's why we have to do that. We do still have power bracelets on sale. Those of you who would like to donate $50 or more will receive our meditation power bracelets. These bracelets here are great for meditation. They are copper and brass, two-tone copper and brass. All of our faculty has one, and we have several hundreds of people who have ordered these bracelets, and they're moving like hotcakes. So definitely be a part of it. we're going to have the Lighthouse power trip coming up too. So be prepared for that. But like I said, the power bracelets, they're $50. Donations of $50 or more, you receive a power bracelet. If you want a Lighthouse t-shirt, Lighthouse t-shirts are donations of $25 or more. This is Lighthouse t-shirt. Lighthouse t-shirt says duality on the front, because you know we do a balance of divine masculine and feminine energy. We don't play around with that. We like to show just as much love to the women as we do the men, and vice versa. So we believe in duality in Africa. Duality, and on the back it says Lighthouse, dua, 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 which means thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, and on the bottom it says nines. You know, we put our nines up every morning. Okay, so we have that going for you guys as well. These are for donations of $25 or more. You get a t-shirt. Okay, what else we got going on? I want to shout out. We want to shout out Joey Badass. Go and cop that album. A couple albums that y'all need to go out and get. That's Joey Badass's All American. You want to cop that. He supports the Lighthouse, so we want to show him our support. He's probably the last conscious rapper alive, man, and he's doing it big. We also want to shout out brother Siggy Potolo. Siggy Potolo has an album out. This is all conscious music, y'all. His album is called The Panther Party. You could cop that on iTunes, Google Play, you know, the whole nine yards. Spotify is out there. It's in stores. Siggy Potolo is also responsible for the t-shirt that I'm wearing today, the Vibranium shirt. He sent me a dope package yesterday of some t-shirts. This is one of them. You can go to his website, okay, and find his stuff there. Sidji Poetolo, if you can, put your information in there. These are the shirts that he sent me yesterday, okay, with the sacred symbols. Awesome, awesome work that he has, okay? And if you put Lighthouse in it, you get these shirts at a discounted rate. A lot of people has been going and grabbing them. I appreciate those who have been going and copping the t-shirts. Percentage of it does come to the Lighthouse. So you go in and you put Lighthouse in it and you'll get a discount. And that discount percentage goes to the Lighthouse. So I appreciate everybody that's been showing their support. The PayPal address is JamarMilton@gmail.com. And Sidji Poetolo, he should have his information in there. If not, we'll put it in there for you guys if you would like to cop the t-shirt from Sidji Poetolo. He is one of my friends on Facebook. The majority of us are on Facebook. So if you want to see the rest of your family, we have roughly almost 20,000 people on there on Facebook. So if you want to see the rest of your family, come on over to Facebook, click follow, and you can be a part of the Lighthouse. Also, shout out to Lisa's Fragrance and Such. Lisa's Fragrance and Such is the one that does my smell goods. She does this stuff called Awesome Sauce. So shout out to her if you want to get some good smell goods from her, from all the different scents, all the different oils. I love Egyptian musk, and she does that for me. Lisa's Fragrance and Such. If you want to get a Reiki reading, once again, that's Latifah Foster. She's on here. She's one of our moderators, actually. You can contact her if you'd like to get a Reiki reading to get your aura back, right? What else we got going on? Okay, yeah, the Lighthouse Power Trip. All right, let me warm y'all up for this, okay? Lighthouse Power Trip is coming. It's going to be in August, towards the end of August, and we are going to Cancun. We're going to Cancun, and we're going to be just having a good time with one another, meditating on the beaches in the mornings, and it's going to be really, really dope. It's something that you want to be a part of. If you haven't joined the Lighthouse group yet, please join the Lighthouse group so you can get all the full details on how to be a part of this event. We're going to be getting it at a much cheaper price than anybody. And if we find it anywhere cheaper, then that means we get to go for free. So we have teamed up with a major travel agency. They're going to be sponsoring us for this trip, and it's going to be dope. It's going to be very, very cheap for us to go for what we're going to be experiencing. It's going to be all inclusive, strictly for the Lighthouse. So be ready within the next couple of days. I'll be giving out the fine details of those who would like to attend and meet up with your family so we can love on one another and meet one another and greet one another. So be prepared for that. And this trip is going to be warming us up for more trips where we get to go to places like Africa and to Kemet and things of that nature. So depending on how we do on this trip, that will set us up for the next trip. So with that being said, what else we got going on? Shout out to Jamario Beard. Jamario Beard does the Black Wall Street t-shirts. If you like a Black Wall Street t-shirt, shout out to, you want to hit up Jamario Beard, okay? These are the Black Wall Street t-shirts. These are all of our sponsors. This is everybody that highly supports the Lighthouse. So we want to show them a lot of love. You know, this is what we do here. So we promote black business because ultimately that's what keeps us going. You know, in the Lighthouse, if you are a business owner and you like to promote some of your stuff on the feed, hit me up in my inbox, okay? And we will promote you on the show, as well as you will be able to get access to the Lighthouse group, where that's all we do in there. All we do is share, trade, buy with one another, and just a lot of love in the group, man. And we try to invite everybody to join. What else we got going on? Melody Mitchell is the one who does my logo tablets here. Shout out to her. Shout out to Melody Mitchell. If you'd like to get some of these done, you can pick whatever photo that you want to put on there, and she will make a nice plate for you. You can hang it up on your wall, or you can use coasters. You can make them, use them as coasters. We also want to shout out Mella Miracle. Mella Miracle is the one that does the lotions. I actually have it in the bathroom right now because I've been using it, but I think I have an extra one here. Mella Miracle has a natural lotion, okay? This is my second jar right here. Mella Miracle is great for your skin, for sensitive skin, okay? And it's also good if you have any cuts, burns, scars that you're trying to get rid of. You can hit up Mella Miracle, M-E-L-A, miracle.com. They also do hair and body oil, okay? Thank you, Mella Miracle, for sending that over. I appreciate it. They also do what we have here is a sugar scrub, okay? And you can use this, you know, you use that in your shower, whatever have you. Okay, good stuff. Shout out to Mella Miracle. Shungite stones. Latifah Foster, if you can, put the link down for the Shungite stones for anybody that would like to purify their water. The water that I'm drinking, it is Shungite water. You can see the different crystals in it. I let you guys know about this every single session. You see the little bubbles in there to let you know that you got the right thing. Okay. What it does is Shungite, it clears the electromagnetic fields. Not only that, it alkalines any water that you're drinking. These stones are only found in Russia, and we have a direct link where you can get those and order those online to alkaline your water. It's important that you drink proper water without fluoride in it, okay? Because the water that we're drinking is very dangerous to the pineal gland and is calcifying our pineal gland, keeping us in this dormant state of subconscious hypnotism. And we have to purify our waters. That's one of the main things that we have to do as a people. So with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Like I said, if you enjoyed this lesson, if it did anything for you, please donate to the Lighthouse PayPal. That's JamarMilton@gmail.com. With that being said, may the divine force in me greet the divine force in you. Dua, 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 family. Thank you. Ashe. Peace.